of centre taps of recent weeks, but it's sharked by Troy Longmuir. Gets a good distance into the kick up toward the forward line, but McLeod is there, goes to his knees, doesn't do much with the footy. Eventually the ball goes to Beswick. He gives a hand pass to Locke. Locke, another hand pass to Howlett. Troy Longmuir, this time he kicks quickly along the ground, well controlled, or was it? No, through the legs of Lacroix, probably should have done better, couldn't control it. Getting another chance though, West Perth, but here is the turnover. Bolton gives it to Howlett, and Howlett steers it pretty well in the defensive 50 then. That's Peel, retained possession under pressure. Now the Bolton kicks a poor one, and there is Jack Darling launching himself into the contest, and he's taken a very good mark.
I wonder if there's any AFL talent scouts come out here to watch him.
Well, they go far and wide, Ryan, as you know. Darling with his first kick that I'm aware of, up towards full forward, no mark. Jones went in, the hand pass not good. Lacroix tapped it out there again for Menengolgan. Falling kick there from Buick.
It was
Matt Tedesco. Good mark taken. That was Darling, who gets the kick from centre wing up toward full forward. It cleared Lacroix. Jones had it tackled, dispossessed. Lacroix swoops on it. He really does know how to make something out of nothing. Brett does. Sends it up towards the left full forward pocket. Awkward bounce. Maybe favour O'Brien. No, over the top of the ball. Knocked to the boundary line by Darling. Rice is there. And we'll see a boundary throw in.
This supported so well as the ball's tossed in. One down in front there by Lacroix. Knocked out of the pack by Crossland. Guadagnin can't control it. In the end, Jones, Kenny had an outstanding first quarter. This is Brown.
Little pass, gives it to Menegola. He's outside 50. A long kick could just about score. Sends it up toward the goal square. Darling was there.
Oh,
Sir Lycus threads the hand pass through to Lacroix.
Shins the ball forward. Still a chance in there for Peel. Bolton tackled. And a player manhandled off the footy. And the free kick is going to go the way of Green.
He gave it to Longmuir, who played the sweeper role very well in the first half. The high kick dropped. Should have been taken by Darling. Plays it pretty cleverly though now, Darling. Gets the hand pass into the path of Salisic. And he seemed to meet Howlett high. Howlett sockers the ball along the ground, made an opportunity for Rosa. Rosa pops a hand pass up to Haynes. Long didn't take the mark, but did extremely well. He was a hard target to grab, gave it to Smoker. Smoker now to Darling. Sends it out wide. Will it be marked? Not what marked out there at all by Crossland. He's outnumbered. Now it's Daniel Haynes who gathers it, swings the right boot into
Salisic, and West Perth out of immediate danger.
Out of immediate danger, and the Salisic kick goes to Darling. Cleverly knocks the ball over his head, then follows it up with Wilson. Both of them teammates, so representing WA in the State 18s Carnival just a few weeks ago. Charters is there. Gets a hand pass only as far as Salikas Flay. Got it to Salisic. He goes from half back to half forward. The fly there from Salikas. They've got their confidence up. Chambers, who hasn't had a big day, still could come into it. Oh, Darling spins out of trouble. Onto the right boot. Misses to the right-hand side. But there was a touch of class there.
And there was a touch of very good awareness too, because when the ball came down and Salikas took the mark, Darling just put his body in the way of a Peel player just to give him the time and space needed to take the mark. So he's a very smart footballer.
The siren surely imminent as Rose.
Right to the siren, West Perth. Chambers kicks up towards the half-forward line. Darling is there, manoeuvred out of the contest. Quinton Bolton, long hand pass to Daniel Hart.
Ford Bolton the mark. Read it best. Hand pass to Brown, Beswick. Off to O'Brien, now out towards Locke. Locke under pressure, gets a hand pass back towards Haynes. He couldn't control it. Darling a fumble, hand pass over his head, hoping for Salisic to run onto it. He did, but he couldn't gain possession. Jones from the other direction, Ken. And just outside 50, it's marked there by Howlett.
Howlett's hand pass to Jones. Oh, played a bit of a dashing game, but he's caught from behind by Harvey. Spilt football picked up by Lask. But now it's Howlett with the footy. Cleverly takes on Darling, the man on his mark. A couple of bounces, then it comes off his shin. Well, that could be the story of it. Here's Morgan, hand passes to Darling. The kick, a little bit premature, went straight to Wilson. He knocked the ball cleverly out to O'Brien. O'Brien to Locke. Locke eventually puts the boot into it. Floats.
Roberts, the general manager of the WAFL. Every hotel room, I think it's 35 beds here in Corrigan, all booked tonight by West Perth and their entourage. Now a free kick on the outer side. Darling held. We're not in possession.
There'll have to be a couple sleeping here at the toe.
Well, yes. Don't really want to go into that.
But leave that alone.
Yeah. hope they do. As Darling comes back and the mark taken by Morgan. Peel actually stayed in Narrogin overnight, so they're driving.
You've just got to be a bit cleverer.
Play on.
Then Burlow with the free kick. Sets it up high. Big pack. Oh, and flying highest is one of the men of the match. Oh, it's young Jack Darling.
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was Coonan there for a while, but Darling is going to be the man of many matches in the future because he is a star in the making, and that was a great mark for a 17-year-old.
A great bill, hasn't he, already?
Who goes to Sacred Heart Sorrento, and one of his teachers is Clayton Lascott, who's playing in the same team as him.
It would be great if Lascott gave him a detention and he had to miss training or something like that.
I just can't see it happening personally as Darling. On his way in, sends the ball straight through the middle, and that's his first goal in WAFL senior football. And West Perth are on their way to a win.
And there's been mobbed by his teammates.
Almost every player's been around him, and good on him. So they should, because he's a player of immense talent. They probably won't see much of him.
Haynes, Daniel Haynes into the corridor. Quite a few Thunder players there, and Bloxage, can you believe it, drops a chest mark. Tunnel balls it back to Locke. Locke beset by West Perth players, and it's all come unstuck. Well,
Tongmuir 60 metres out on the lead, and the mark is taken by Darling.
Go back and have a shot.
Yep.
And his teammates are telling him to.
Jack Darling celebrated his first goal in league footy, playing his first ever game at the 7-minute mark of this final quarter. Led out powerfully there in front of another young man in Blaine Wilson. Strong grab.
Got one for his troubles too.
So wonder how big this boy will be after he has a couple of years of AFL full-time conditioning. He's already quite broad for a 17-year-old. Certainly tall. Runs at the man on the mark. And he's drifting off well and truly to the left. He didn't read that. He's not an orphan. A lot of balls have gone out of play on the full on that outer side as Bolton restarts.
Tedesco this afternoon. Between the two of them, what did I say? I beg your pardon, Salisic it was. Salisic taken away there by Jones. Bloxage over the top to Jones, and away goes Jones again from half back.
Towards the middle of the ground, then goes long and direct. Darling the target over his head at the back. Bolton unfortunately fell over. Now Lacroix with it, goes for his fourth and ices the goal. Then to a stationary Tedesco, Matt Tedesco. He kicks it high over the wing, leaning over from the back was Darling. He couldn't mark. Running through is Wilson. He kicks to space out in front of Big Robin.
Tedesco, they're sharing it around a bit. Eventually the kick comes from Luke Tedesco, way up over the members' wing. Warden looks as though he got a bit of a push. Locke is there. Hand pass to Howlett, who's nearly out on his feet. Put his head down. Fight a hand pass forward, but only as far as Troy Longmuir to Van Berlo.